The president's assent to the Anti-Homosexuality Act has triggered widespread international reactions, with human rights organizations and advocacy groups expressing concern over its potential impact on the rights and freedoms of the LGBTQ plus community. This comes amid fears that donor partners might slash their cash contributions.
But my challenge to the Western world is that don't single out individuals. Do it to all of us. Then we will know that you are fair. Number two, I was speaking to my colleagues in Ghana. In Ghana, they've even gone ahead to threaten freezing accounts. Freezing accounts. And slapping bans on international banking institutions that partner with the US banks and other financial institutions. So if you have monies on your accounts and you have a salary, remove it.
The mover of the bill, Asuman Basalirwa, disclosed to the press that the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, has become the first victim of the bill by the United States of America revoking her visa.
This is an email from US Embassy. And dear Madam Speaker, the United States government has revoked your current visas on information that came available after your last issuance. As of May 12, 2023, you don't possess a valid travel visa to the US, though you are welcome to apply again. Please forward your passport to the embassy through Ministry of Finance so that we can make necessary modifications to your visas. I think they were looking for my visa for the US. They didn't find it. So the first victim is the speaker. And I understand even the UK government is doing the same.
While addressing journalists yesterday, Basalirwa said that it had come to their notice that the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among's visa, had been revoked by the USA government. However, it remains uncertain whether it had to do with her role in the formulation and subsequent passing of the anti-homosexuality bill.
That both the American embassy and the British embassy have communicated to the Speaker of Parliament of Uganda about cancellation of her visas. And it is these communications came this morning after information went through that the president had assented to the law. So don't have any guess or second thoughts. It is information on record.
Basalirwa, however, says this development shouldn't weaken Ugandans' resolve to expunge this vile vice.
Let us now consider looking for development partners. And I am ready to champion the cause of going to the Arab world to look for donor support.
The born-again faith churches have warned that high-profile political actors in Uganda should be ready to face repercussions following the president's assent to the Anti-Homosexuality Bill 2023.
Ugandans, especially those in high places of leadership, are about to face and should be ready for reactionary and serious repercussions. Visas may be cancelled, visits may be denied, but that is common when people are angry.
Sarah Da welcomed the law but urged government to give a window for amnesty to gays and lesbians ready to reform and allow churches to set up recovery centers.
To allow religious leaders to establish recovery centers. There are people who wish to walk away from that lifestyle and would want to find counseling and advice so that they can live a totally different life.
Other members of parliament have welcomed the new law and tasked government to smoothen its implementation.
I want to appreciate the president for only this time that he has been able to sign the People's Act. And I do believe that every Ugandan has appreciated this because we have Christian values that we follow. And as such, we want to say thank you.
Relatedly, religious leaders have today celebrated the president's decision to append his signature on the anti-gay bill. Pastor Martin Semper of Makere Community Church and Pastor Aloysius Bujingo of House of Prayer Ministries couldn't hide their joy on receiving the news of President Museveni's approving of the tough new anti-homosexuality law.
Today is good news for us. Today, His Excellency, the President of Uganda, Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, has done the people of Uganda proud when he finally signed the Anti-Homosexual Bill 2023 into law. I want to thank all of you who have been in prayer, advocacy, fighting for this victory. The real work begins now that we are armed with the law.
His Excellency has not signed this law for this government. He has signed the law for generations and generations until the second coming of Christ.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi and Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.
Red card, see ya yellow.